The government calls Mr. Darryl Arnold. Mr. Arnold, raise your right hand, please. Please be seated and state and spell your name for the record. Darryl Arnold for the record. Would you spell your name, please? Darryl, D-A-R-R-Y-L, A-R-N-O-L-D, Arnold. Good afternoon, Mr. Arnold.
Good afternoon.
How are you doing, sir?
I'm fine, thank you.
Mr. Arnold, where are you from?
I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana.
What area of New Orleans?
St. Rock area.
Have you lived in that area your entire life?
Yeah, I lived in that area my entire life.
Mr. Arnold, are you incarcerated right now?
Yeah, I'm incarcerated.
Do you have any prior felony convictions?
Prior felony convictions? Yeah.
The last 10 years?
Last 10 years. Yes, sir.
Isn't it true you were convicted 2006?
Judge, I would object to him leading his witness.
Do you have any prior felony convictions?
Yes, sir.
What are they in the last 10 years?
Possession of marijuana, possession of crack cocaine.
I can't hear him.
Possession of marijuana, possession of crack cocaine.
Right now, you're incarcerated, correct?
Yes, sir.
You have two pending charges?
Yes, sir.
Have any promises been made to you with regard to those promises?
No, sir. No promises at all.
Are you familiar with R.o.d?
Yeah, I heard about them. I'm familiar with them.
Do you know what it is? What is that?
Sir?
Do you know what that is?
Yes, I know what it is. From my knowledge, you know, I was locked up and a lot of people were aware of me what it was.
What is it?
It was a gang.
Where did that gang? Where did you know that gang to hang out?
Where I know the gang to hang out?
Yes.
The St. Rock area.
Okay. Can you tell me who was R.O.D.? Any members that you know about?
Yeah, I know a few of them from growing up with them.
Can you give me some names, please?
I know Big Baby, Pug, a guy, Duda Man. I don't really know him. I heard of him.
Big Baby, can you tell me if you could look in a courtroom and tell me whether or not you see that person here? And if so, point him out and describe what he's wearing.
Yeah, I see him.
Can you tell us what he is wearing?
He is wearing a green t-shirt, a green sweater. A green shirt, button-down shirt.
Can you tell me what the person beside him to his right might be wearing?
Duda Man, I know him from people telling me.
No, what I'm asking, can you tell me what the person sitting beside?
He is standing up right now. Oh, his lawyer, look like a defendant.
Your Honor, I ask the record reflect the identification of Mr. Byron Jones.
No, it should reflect that.
You said you know Duda Man? Did you say that?
Yeah, I know him from, you know, people telling me about the situation with my uncle with him. But as far as, I can't hear the witness, Judge. If he could speak more clearly and loudly. Just try to speak right into the microphone as loudly as you can. I know him from the situation with people telling me with my uncle. Yes, sir.
If you see him in a courtroom, will you please point him out and describe what he is wearing as well?
He is wearing a white button-down shirt with the female sitting next to him.
Your Honor, I ask the record to reflect the identification of Mr. Sidney Patterson.
Any objection?
No objection.
So indicated.
You also referenced a pug. If you see him in a courtroom, can you do the same and describe what he is wearing?
Yes, sir. He wearing a blue button-down shirt with a guy sitting next to him, the attorney.
Your Honor, I ask the record to reflect the identification of Mr. Deloyd Jones.
Any objection? No objection. The record should so indicate.
Thank you. Mr. Arnold, do you know a person by the name of Travis Arnold?
Yeah, that's my uncle.
Where is your uncle?
Deceased right now.
Do you know when he died?
Sometime in 2010. Have you ever had any conversations with the person you call Big Baby about your uncle?
Yeah, I had some conversations with him.
Can you tell us about it?
We was in jail. We ran into each other in jail. It was a time he was on a rec yard or whatever.
I can't understand the witness. I'm sorry.
It was a time we ran into each other in jail. We was incarcerated, and I saw him on the rec yard. And from on the rec yard, he told me that, I'm gonna kill Travis and make you cry. You hear me? I'm like, what's that about? He just pointed back at me again and was like, I'm gonna kill Travis and make you cry. And then so I'm like, I went and called Travis and told him, dude gonna do something to you, you know, watch your back, you know, something prepare, dude. He said, man, I ain't worrying about the situation. Just get home.
As you were just talking just now, you were doing some movements with your hands.
Yes.
Is that part of the conversation that you had?
Yeah, he was like, I'm gonna kill Travis and make you cry. Like, you know.
Who was doing that?
Big Baby.
What did you do in response to that?
I know you said you called your uncle.
Did you do anything else?
No, I just went back to my bunk and just kind of contemplated and just was like, you know, I couldn't see where it was coming from.
How did that make you feel?
Made me feel bad. It was my uncle, you know, God grew it up all my life with.
You identified a person you called Duda Man.
Right.
When is the last time you saw him?
Last time I saw him, he was somewhere off in a lockup. He was getting transferred.
Let me ask you this. In the last few years, how many times have you seen him? Can you tell me the number of times you've seen him?
I must have seen him 2 times.
Tell me about the first time that you saw him and where it was.
The first time I saw him in a St. Rock Park on a detail.
What do you mean by detail?
I was working for the Broad Street Work Release Program, and I ran in contact with him on St. Rock Park one day. And he was like, you know, he just looked at me and my sisters and a bunch of other girls like, no, don't go over there. He gonna kill you and all this here. And I'm like, man, I'm not trying to hear all that. Who the guy who killed Travis here? And they was like, that's him over there. And I just looked, he looked, and somebody went and told the deputies, and the deputies worried something is going on. So from there, he called me to the truck and we relocated to another spot.
Did he say anything to you?
No, he just gave me a look, you know, that's all. He gave me a look.
Did anything in particular stand out about him? What was he doing? What was he wearing, rather?
All I can really say, nothing particular about anything stand out. He had a gun on him, that's about it. And he was just looking, his dreads down, like, looking at me like, you know. From there, the deputy had called me, and I had to relocate back to the truck.
Where was the gun? And tell us about it. Describe it.
I believe it was on one of his left hips, left shoulder, one of them, one of these sides it was on. Because I was really trying to get back to the truck, but I saw him from there fixing his brief area or something.
Can you describe the gun?
No, I can't describe it.
Did you have any other encounters with Big Baby? Let me ask you this before I ask that question. The encounter you just described, was that before or after Travis was killed? The one you just described at the St. Rock Park.
That was after.
Did you have any other conversations with him or encounters with him after the first one you just described? That being Big Baby?
Yeah, I came in contact with him again at the Central Lockup in New Orleans. I had some traffic stuff I was going through lockup for. From there, one guy had bum rushed me, and like he was like on some type of scared situation.
I'm sorry. Again, I cannot understand what he is saying. Try to speak clearly.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Can you say that again?
Yes, ma'am. I came through the lockup on some traffic stuff, and one guy, he was like, he was scared from the situation. He bum rushed me and was like, I ain't had nothing to do with Travis getting killed. Stuff like this. He said, the guy who killed him is over there. So from that time, you know, dude, he had been done cut his dreadlocks, so I ain't really know who he was.
So when I reached to try to approach him, he just came out with the statement like, "See where your uncle at, huh? You see where your uncle at?" And the deputies like grabbed me and stuff like, and put me in another part of the jailhouse. "Who was this you were just describing just now?" "Dude, a man.